Hey guys, what's up? I'm Matt, and in this video we're gonna install WordPress locally offline on your computer. We're gonna do this step by step, so let's dive in right now. To get the free software, you can click over here or go to wampserver.com. Now we are at the WAMP Server website. As you can see, it's completely French, but click over here to English and here we go. Now we can start using this piece of software. Press on Start Using WAMP Server and choose the version you want. Now this is only for Windows computers. If you have a Mac, you need to go to mamp.info and press Enter. And then you need to click on here on this Apple icon. Then we have the Mac version over there, and you can download it and install it and try it. I'm not gonna create a tutorial about this one because I don't have a Mac. So good luck with that one. If you now click on this one, you can see the entire form you can fill in, but it's optional. You can also click on here. You can download it directly. Just click on it. Then we go to SourceForge over there. And after 4 seconds, you can actually download the software. 644 MBs. So it's gonna take a while. Once you have downloaded it, run it and then click on yes. And select the language during installation, English. Then we see this screen, which is very important to notice that you have to install it in CWAMP or DWAMP and no spaces or diacritics in your folder. Very important. So when you click on next, you can see that it's been installed on CWAMP 64. Well, we can just use CWAMP, should be excellent. Press next. Just leave this on default installation. You will get Apache, PHP, Maria Database, MySQL and PHP MyAdmin. So that's all pretty good. Press next. And press next. Then we press install. Gonna take a while, so sit back, drink some water, drink some tea, and enjoy. If you want to choose another browser, press yes, or else just press no, it's okay. Do you want to choose another text editor? No. Press next. And then we press finish. Now we have the WAMP server installed on our computer. If you open your start menu and you type in WAMP and you start the WAMP manager, just press on yes. All services are running. You can't see it entirely on my screen in here. You can go up here. And you can also see now that this one is the WAMP Server 3.30 and it's running right now. So this is really great. Now, what do we need to do right now is just press on exit over there and it's gonna shut down all the services. Yes. And we're gonna start it again. Just go to WAMP Server 64 and click on it. Yes again. It's going to start all the different kinds of services that we need, so be patient. And it's ready. Then we're going to open up the browser that we choose during install. In my case, it's Edge. Type in localhost and press enter. If you see this screen, then you're good to go. We're ready to move on to install WordPress. If you don't see this screen and some things are broken, drop it down in the comments. I'll try to help you. Open up a new tab and we go wordpress.org. In there we go to press get WordPress and we're gonna and then press download WordPress over there. Go to where you've downloaded and press on extract all. Now this is very important. Then we need to unpack it in CWAMP www. Click on it and press select map like this. Saying something like this. This is very important or else it won't work. Now we press extract. Here we go, gonna take a while, so sit back and relax. All right, well done. Go back to your local host over here and just refresh this page with using F5. If you can now see, there is a new project here called WordPress. And that means the file has been added successfully, but we cannot use it just yet. We have to add a virtual host. So we click on this button and we're gonna name it WordPress over there. Then we're gonna the absolute path. This is your path, cwamp www/WordPress over here. And then we're gonna click on this one and we're gonna use PHP 8.0 and we're gonna press start creation. It was created or modified. All right. Then we need to restart DNS. You go over here and you click on your WAMP icon and we go to tools and we're gonna press on restart DNS. Click on it. Then it's just gonna run a couple of things, updating the settings, restarting the DNS. That should do it. And we click on back to homepage over here. And now we are here and we have a new virtual host called WordPress. If we now click on this button, you will go to your website. Wow, this is amazing. It just works. We are at the WordPress setup. Well done. Now, what we need to do is choose the language you want to build your offline website in. I want to build it in English. Press continue. and we press on let's go. Then we fill in the database name, but we don't have a database just yet. So what are we gonna do? Leave this open, go to a new tab, type in localhost again, like this. Then we go over here to phpMyAdmin, click on it, and then you are at phpMyAdmin. Click on here, databases, right there. We're gonna add in a name over there, so click on it and type in, for example, WordPress site, like this, and press create. Here we go. Now we have a new database, which is called WordPress underscore site. Now, back to the WordPress setup configuration. Type in the database name, WordPress underscore site, or the name you just created. Put it in over there. Username should be root, no password, localhost is good, and then the table prefix, you should change this because we don't want to use this one. Type in some random number like this and press submit. Now it's gonna connect to the database on your computer to install WordPress itself. Be patient, it's gonna take a while. All right, Sparky, press run the installation. And then we are here at the famous 5 minute, well, I would say 30 seconds installation of WordPress. Enter in your site title, username, password, and your email address. You can change it later on, but just fill in your site title. For example, my first website, the username should be Matt. Your password, make sure to copy your password and then fill in your email address and press install WordPress. Is that simple? Yeah, it's that simple. Don't worry if this takes a few minutes, all will be good. Here we go, WordPress has been installed. Thank you and enjoy. Press on login over there. We fill in our username and our password we've just created. And press on login like this. Welcome to WordPress. Your website has been installed locally and only you can see it. So you don't have to send out this to someone else because it will not work. Now, if you want to learn how to create an amazing website, check out this video and I'll teach you step by step how to create this amazing website. You can skip the part about getting hosting because you already have it. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop it down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button if I helped you out and subscribe over there if you want to see more WordPress related videos. Of course, check out this video, which I'll show you how to create the most amazing WordPress website completely offline on your system. Have a nice day and I'll see you later.